Today we see nucleophiles and electrophiles. These are the two reagents in organelles. Nucleophile, a species that can donate a pair of electrons, that is called. The species will be having a pair of electrons attached to that, or like CH minus, OH minus. The species which can donate. Also can donate a pair of electrons. You can donate a pair of electrons. NS3 can donate a pair of electrons. So any species which is able to donate a pair of electrons is called nucleophile. And the species which can accept a pair of electrons is called electrophile. CH3 plus, it is having a positive charge. It can accept a pair of electrons. Of course, it can take a pair of electrons. So that is electrophile. This is nucleophile. Now, here I have written three compounds. You can show where the arrows to make the reaction in the release. Find out the reaction in the release. If the following zones are broken, heterolytically. Yesterday we learned about this heterolytic fission and homolytic fission. So heterolytically, the bond is broken. The bonds are shown here. Three bonds are shown here. Of course, there is a cohesion essence, but that is not shown here. But this means find out the reaction intermediates by using curved arrows. What are reaction intermediates we can get? See sulfur. Sulfur is more electrolytic. So curved arrow for heterolytic cleavage shown like. So here we have the CH3 plus and SH3 minus. These are the two reactions in the previous. These things will be formed during the reaction in the reaction action. Here the bond is between C and C, but nitrogen is there on the second attached to the second C, that is backside of the electron will be shifted because nitrogen is more electrolytic. So it will be moving to that carbon, and here again CH3 plus. The atom which is just lost the electron broadcast and we are seeing a light. What about here? This is metal. Metals are electropositive. That when carbon is electronegative, so we will be shifting the signs. We see minus and Cu plus. So, by checking which atom is more electronegative or more electropositive, you can shift that electron pair. That bonded pair of electrons can be shifted to more electronegative atom. Then that atom will be negative, and the atom which has lost the electron, that is positive. Now, write one question. Identify the electrophilic sender. Identify the electrophilic sender. Identify the electrophilic sender in the following CH3CX4O and CH3CN, which is the electrophilic sender CH3I. Electrophilic sender means you have to look for the positive atom, positively nature atom. Of course, CH3CX4O. Oxygen is more electronegative, so it will be shifted here. So this carbon is electrophilic sender. So I am marking this carbon and the star mark over there to show that electrophilic sender. So here, CH3CF, which is electrophilic sender. Nitrogen is more electronegative, so this carbon is. So you can select the most appropriate answer. And here, this carbon is the electrophilic center. Means that atom is attached to more electronegative atom. So the more electronegative atom is a shared pair of electrons towards it. So the other atom will be having a positive center. So that is the electrophilic center. Next, we are moving to electron movements. In organic chemistry, while doing the reactions, there are movement of electrons, shifting of electrons from one place to the other. What are types of shifts we observe generally in organic chemistry? These are the basic principles. Using this will be doing the reactions further. Suppose there is an atom C or Y, any atom X, Y, Z. Suppose there is a bond, there is a double bond this side and single bond that side. Double bond means one is super bond, one is pi bond. Pi bond is a loose bond that can be easily polarized. Suppose this bond is pi bond that will polarize purely. So what you are getting is like this. This is one possibility. And from that, you can show this is falling to. So what happens? See, double bond, yes, single bond. There is another possibility. Oh. Look at this one, this C, this one. It is directly jumping here, shifting there, moving there. So what we are doing is C, this side, so we want that side, W. So these are the three ways of shifting in organic chemistry. So let's apply this in this. For example, I'm giving you point one bond. Sure. And what are ways the electrons can be shifted? CH2 double bond, CH single bond, CH double bond, CH. What is the name of this compound? What is the name of this compound? Say unsaturation. More than one unsaturation should be with the 1,3-diene. Buta 1,3-diene. Now, you see, this bond can be shifted here, this can be shifted here, that is edge 1, you cannot go past that. So, maximum shifting is less. So, this carbon is losing, that carbon will be positive. The one where the electrons are lost, that is positive. And here, this bond is coming to this side, that means C as double bond, and then C as, and this pair of electrons is shifting. This pair of electron is shifting, so C, H, the current. So one end is positive and the other end is negative. I have shown the shifts. This double shifts I have shown and both changes to electron. That also I have shown. So two types of shifts are visible in this view now. What do we need? Now, electron displacement in normal bonds. Electron displacement affects electron displacement effect. Displacement effect in covalent bonds. In covalent bonds. First one is inductive effect. First one is inductive effect. What is inductive? Right after. Polarization of sigma bond. Polarization of sigma bond. Polarization of sigma bond. Caused by the polarization of adjacent sigma bond. Caused by the polarization of adjacent sigma bonds. Caused by the polarization of adjacent sigma bond. Is referred to as inductive effect. in that they effort. This effect is passed on to the subsequent bones also. The subsequent bones also. But the effect decreases rapidly. As the number of intervening bones increases. Intervening bones increases and becomes vanishingly small. Vanishes, disappears, and becomes vanishingly small after three bones. So what is an indirect effect? Let us see it. Bones. See, you think more than that, like you can put in the shade of the process. So, see this, and that will be after the deposit. This is a polar bones. Colon bones. Now, look at this molecule. Delta positive. That doesn't show that the quantity in magnitude is more. No. Plus. Single delta positive. This is getting much closer. Just like if you are standing near the fire, you are very close to the fire, you get more heat. As you move far away from the fire, you are not getting that much amount of heat. So, the same way, the effect is less as you move from one carbon to the other. So, here, this delta, magnitude is maximum here, but here it is minimum here. The polarization of the sigma bond, possible polarization of adjacent sigma bond is called contact field. Now, why your question? In which CC bond? In which CC bond? In which CC bond of CC3? Inductive effect is expected to be the least. 1, 2, 3. That means between C2 and C3. Between C2 and C3, inductive effect is expected to be the least because that is the farthest. After that, no inductive effect. Next, we are moving to resonant structures. Resonance structure. The typical example what I'm giving is benzene. Benzene, there are three double bonds. And it's alternate single that double bonds. We know that means double bond means double attraction. So bond length will be less. This is our expectation. Here single bond means that is more number than the double bond. Double bond means double attraction. Single bond means single attraction. But when we measure the bond length experimentally, we are not getting short bond length. We are not getting longer bond length. We are getting same bond length. Same bond length. Though I have double bonds and triple bonds, not like that. Now, a double bond and triple bond can say this is a resonating domain. This double bond is a resonating domain in these places. So here, this might be shown like this. Maybe between these stars or a carbon atom. Then the double bond is between C1 and C2. Sim, foi assim. E até na forma que você quer. Então, é assim. Por exemplo, esse está sendo possível. So, you know, we cannot say where is the double point. It is moving between them around all this power. So, this is not the real structure. This is not the real structure. The real structure is in between these two structures. That is what we call Russell's hybrid of the Russian community. That is called the Russell's hybrid. That Russell's hybrid is what we are showing like this. That is. You draw this hexagon and show you what it is. It is present all around. So obviously show that it is not easy. So what we do, we put one hexagon and we draw like this. This is the resonance structure. This is the resonance structure. Oh, this is a canonical form. This is the canonical form. This is called the resonance. This is called the resonance pipe. So this has got some amount of energy, this has got some amount of energy, both energies are equal. But this has got the lower energy than these one and that is most stable structure. The energy difference between the resonance hybrid and the lowest energy canonical form. That is called the resonance energy. This has got the lowest energy. And these are the canonical forms. In this case, both canonical forms are similar, so their energies are same. So the energy difference between the resonance hybrid and the lowest energy canonical form, that is called resonance energy. Let's see another example for resonance. That is R is equal to N double bond pole, single bond pole. Nitrogen pole bonds plus charge. So this can enter here, then it can go there, it can resonance. So I can write the next structure, resonance structure, that is H3. M. Now here is the double bond, this, and here is the double bond. This again plus. That can again come here and this can go here to make the first structure. So there are two resonating structures for this. There are two resonating structures. This is another example. Similar is the case with acetate. Now, in these resonance structures, suppose among these resonance structures, one is without any charge. Without any charge, after that, if the electron negative atom is carrying a negative charge, that is better. So, the least energy is least energy will be taken by one. The structure with no charges, no positive negative separation. Less charge separation means more stability. After that, the structure in which electron negative atom is having negative charge, that is better. Then, better means the best structure is with no charge separation. The most stable structure is. Most stable structure is with no charge separation. No charge separation. Then, after that, you check for the electronegative atom carrying anything charge. Then, the other structure. Suppose electronegative atom carrying a positive charge. That's not good. That is the worst structure. So let's see one example for that. That goes CH2, double bond, CH, single bond, CH2. Take no charge. So let's see, you don't see any positive or negative charge. and show electron shift like this and like this. So are you getting another answer? CH0, this rather positive, and the CH double bond C, then this minus, then X. This is the best structure that is the most stable and without any charge. This, after that, stability goes to this one, that is electron negative atom carrying negative charge, electron positive atom carrying positive charge. Now you consider the same molecule with the opposite shift. This is coming here and this is coming here. So I am writing this as other structure, but it is not a stable structure. This power is having a negative charge. Power is having a negative charge, which is the single bond C is double bond. C is single bond O plus. Electronegative atom O is carrying a positive charge, so it is not a good structure. The most stable structure is this one. This one. Then two. The least stable is this 3. So stability order is 1, 2, 3. Why current is the least stable? Why? Because the electronegative atom carrying positive charge is not a good structure. So you can, in resonance structures, some are very stable structures, some are very less stable structures. Next we are moving to resonance effect.
So, inducting effect, resonance effect in conjugation. So, resonance effect, that is positive resonance, positive resonance. Example, this chlorine. This chlorine is having electron pair. This pair of electron enter here and this can go there. So you will be getting a resonance structure. Here, double bond. C has lost some electron pairs, so I'm writing a positive charge and chlorine. And this way, carbon is getting electron pairs, and this one like a negative carbon or carbon. Now, this bond was there, this bond was. The one which is losing carrying positive charge. Alright. So, next the resonance structure. See, this can enter here at the same time, this can go in. So, if you look at the next resonance structure, that is, this is fine. You see, plus, I don't want to show all the electrons, all the electrons on the back. So here a new bond has come and here. And this can end up here and this can go here. The next resonance structure is obtained. That is, this is minus this one, and the bond C and plus. And the next resonance, this can end up here and this can go back. So the fifth resonance factor is possible. Fifth resonance factor is possible. That is double bond. Here again, second bond. And that when the electron enters the positive charge, it becomes neutral. So there are five resonance structures. There are five resonance factors. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are five resonance structures. This is positive resonance effect means After the ozone phase, electrons are towards the wind.
In the electrons are pointed towards the wind, or you can say chlorine is pushing electron rings in the wind. This we represent as plus R. Plus R effect of chlorine. Chlorine is an electron, the wind will grow. Positive resonance effect is a subsequent phase, donating electron density. Now let's see negative resonance effect. When an electron drawing group is attached to the benzene ring, the electron will be pulled from the benzene ring. So we call it as negative resonance effect. Now that I'm taking benzene ring, which is connected to a nitro group, where this is plus, minus, plus, here is minus. As a whole, the molecule is neutral. Now, nitro group is an electron withdrawing group that withdraws the electron density from the benzene ring. Problem is possible since this becomes, this is pulled by oxygen. At the same time, this is coming here. So you are getting the next resonance structure. That is, here double bond N, this goes here already, plus, then this is minus. This carbon is losing, so carbon is possible charge over there. This goes here, this goes here. Now this is moving that side. So, this carbon is losing, so this carbon will be positive. That is, this is positive. Here, double bond. Here, N, O, minus, then O, minus, minus, carrying positive charge. Okay, here is the bond. Now, this will end up here. Here is the bond. This becomes positive. Here, N. Right, look at it, positive charge. Reservoir of this comes here. Then the next resonance factor, that is N. When what will happen? This will be entering again back. So double bond to O, single bond to O minus, positive. Here bond, here bond, here. Again, there are five resonance structures. This is nitrobenzene. Nitro group is an electron withdrawing group. Next is electromeric effect that we will be doing in the next class.